Hey guys, can I get in? Yesterday she announced she's deploying National Guard troops from South Dakota to Texas at Abbott's request. Get this, funded by a private donation from a billionaire Republican donor who has donated over $500,000 to Donald Trump the last 2 years.
The breaking news for you is that you're sending troops from here to Texas to aid with the border. Why did you decide to make that move?
Well, typically securing the border would be the responsibility of the federal government, but our federal government is not doing their job. And we know that we have dangerous people crossing the border. We have a lot of drugs coming into our country. We have a lot of human trafficking going on. The governors of Texas and Arizona have asked us for help, and this is a mission that National Guard is trained and equipped and does with excellence.
You did not even know, I will confess, it was possible or legal to privately fund the movement of American troops.
When they made the request to me, I started running the protocols, asking if we had volunteers in my National Guard that would want to do this mission and had more than I could possibly anticipate,
so
would
Governor,
want to
you
go.
You actually went and talked with those men and women.
Yeah,
and they volunteered.
They volunteered to go because they understand how important it is to secure that border. And in fact, my tag came back and said, we have more that would like to, if this is a mission that needs to last longer than the original 30 days that we're planning.
But of course, this makes sense when you think about the different prisms through which governing performance is evaluated. We all understand that Joe Biden's job is to get the country running again, to keep people safe and healthy and get America on its feet. And Republicans understand their job is to keep feeding performative nonsense to a base with an insatiable and apparently depthless appetite for it.
And our law enforcement officers would have gone too. The question for us is, most of these law enforcement officers you see going from other states are going for a 14-day deployment. It's not going to be over in 14 days. In fact, it's going to get much worse. And the National Guard is used to being there, getting a mission, accomplishing it, and being in situations exactly like they're going to see and encounter down there on the border. It's dangerous. And then they come home. South Dakota's had the number one ranked National Guard unit in the country for the last 3 years. So I have the best. I have the best, and I'm going to send my best because this country deserves the best.
And as a Texan, we say thank you because we are being hit the hardest by the... I got to...